After a two-month break, it's time to go racing again. Testing, refining and wondering ends now as we prepare for round two of the Continental Tire Sports Car Challenge Series. This is the Barber 200 at the glorious Barber Motorsports Park in Birmingham, Alabama. And what about that Subaru starting on the second row? They are pumped. They're ready to go. The new Porsche for the Rum Bum Boys and the CKS Camaro team starting from the pole. Let's go. Let's see what Lawson Aschenbach can do. Down into turn one. Good clean start there. The Aston Martin tucks into second. Brett Spouty into third in the Subaru. Whoa! Oh, one car way out of control. Two one. Out of control.
Four, five, six cars involved. Yeah. One car right over the top of the other, the 122.
Enzo Pottolicchio there. We've got one of the Mitchum Motorsport Camaros there. That was wild stuff. Watch this. Watch this. Down the inside of the BMW. That's Pottolicchio.
And the 22 Mustang, they climbed literally over the top of the black Camaro, the 6, went over the roof.
Just want to make a correction. It was Pottolicchio who was getting partially airborne in the middle. He was not that car that went down the inside. The 02 there with damage. We're going to clean this up, come back, and update you who is where.
The number 14 Nissan and Patrick Dempsey all got a quick tap there. There you see all of the cars that were involved in that crash. Major, major car.
Oh, another big crash right at the start. God. Roush's Mustang involved again. It's not over with yet. Look at this.
And more cars getting airborne. Shelby Blackstock was in the middle of that one. It's the 97 Turner Motorsport car.
Here we go. That one's done.
That's Michael Marcel, and that was a pretty heavy hit too, as you can see, with an hour, 35 minutes left in this 2.5 hour event, ready to go with Lawson Aschenbach at the front of this field where he has been the entire time.
Green, green, green.
The pole sitter. Now here's green, green, green. Let's go racing. Keep it clean, boys. Let's circulate some laps. How about the Subaru for Phoenix Performance sitting in second place with Brett Spouty? This is really encouraging stuff. Brett's got by that the machine of Joe Foster, the Aston Martin Vantage. Inside move by the 45 four-line BMW on the sister car.
So everybody's just feeling the cars out for the first time.
Tony Rivera is in there in that black and orange BMW. Round the outside goes Matt Plum in the Porsche. Is he going to pull it off? Yes, he does. The
Beautiful
Rumbum
move.
Porsche the second.
That was fantastic. He set him up perfectly and just carried monster speed into that turn-in point for that chicane and just carried it through.
Some 29 laps coming up the clock over to 30 laps. And all the while... The 74 goes around of Adam Burrows.
Buckley didn't come back into traffic. Was sure trying to. Adam got it stopped.
Really good for recovery. But look up front. And talking about the Aston Martin making a one-stop strategy, that's cool. But remember, the Rum Bum car will only need one more stop as well, and they need to put less fuel on board than the Aston. Let's see this. Brake zone down into five.
I think he'll get him this time. He's got position going in.
Position, yeah. He read it the last time, realized how strong the Aston was. He tries to cut back under, but Matt takes the track position away from good clean move.
And how about this? CJ Wilson's Mazda team out in front with Mark Miller behind the wheel. Jason Saini, let's climb aboard the 26. Speaking of Mazda MX-5s, this is the 26 of Andrew Carbonell chasing the sister car of Tom Long. Leading this ST class is Mark Miller for CJ Wilson's Mazda team. Then you got Tyler McQuarrie back in third. Greg Lafouge for Bimmerworld is second in this class, so that's a good run for the Bimmerworld boys.
Oh, the Subaru in trouble. I think that's got it. Might have blown up. There's smoke underneath. It looks like it might have gotten in the wall.
Wow.
I think this is a mechanical failure, though.
Strong second place run going there, Dorsey.
Yeah, it was a very good run, and they worked hard on the Subaru. If it blew the engine up, yep, we got one, all right. Fourth one of this race so far.
Look at Dave Empringham pulling out of the line in that Tower Events BGB Porsche, the silver and blue machine, looking for a way through. Couldn't quite get there. The four-line BMWs are door-to-door again. Look at those guys going hard at it. The 48 and the 46. Hugh Plum and Charles Espenlaub going at it. Up over the brow of the hill. They may have even touched there. Check this out here. We've got some team cars together. Oh, and guess what? The 12 and the 25 are still going at it.
Wow, that is wild.
That was crazy stuff right there. Look what happened to Steve Randall in the Mustang here. Gets in with way too much speed.
Oof.
Gets himself, puts the power down, nails it, and squeaks his way right on out of there.
How about this? On debut, the Rum Bum, no more BMW. It's a Porsche these days. And Plum and Longy drive all the way to victory lane. How about that? Well done to Greg Lafouge. How about this? The Bimmerworld boys, they're going to drive to victory lane. Greg Lafouge is going to handle the pressure. So it's a BMW, a Kia, and a Honda 1, 2, and 3 at Barber Motorsports Park.